Over one weekend in April 2018, we travelled to Albany, Western Australia, to study how plastics are distributed horizontally and vertically across four beach locations with different environmental conditions. The four locations we chose were the East and West Ends, Mutton Bird and Cozy Corner respectively, of Torbay Beach and the East and West Ends of Anvil Beach. We hypothesised that the vertical and horizontal distribution of plastics at the two beaches would be different, with a higher abundance of plastics at the west end of Torbay and the east end of Anvil Beach, and a higher abundance in the upper layers of beach sediment compared to lower layers. The plastics problem is a relatively new area of science, therefore it is important to build up baseline data. This is useful in determining if the problem is becoming better or worse. From a management perspective, beach cleanups are becoming an important part of plastic removal from coastal areas. We want to ensure time and resources invested into cleanup efforts are used efficiently as possible. It is useful to know where plastic collects on beaches so that debris removal actions can be focused there. Our findings also help raise awareness of how much and what types of plastics are arriving on Albany beaches. At first glance, our beaches look clean. However, our research told a very different story.
We found there was a significantly higher abundance of plastic, including fibres, at Mutton Bird Beach than Cozy Corner, but no significant difference in abundance between Anvil East and Anvil West. Plastic, therefore, is not distributed evenly across beaches with different currents, wave energies, and beach morphologies. Beach cleanups in Albany should focus on Mutton Bird Beach. When organising regular cleanups for a certain beach, a preliminary study should be completed to identify areas of high plastic concentration. There was no significant difference in abundance of plastics between the three depth layers. This is something that should be considered when designing methods for beach cleanups. Plastic is not only found on the surface of the beach, but also to a depth of at least 15 centimetres. The average size of plastics was significantly smaller at Anvil Beach compared to Torbay. This may be a result of the nearby reef coupled with higher wave energy, which could be causing plastics to break down into smaller pieces. The most important thing we've realised is that we need to stop using plastic. Mutton Bird Beach looks like a pristine environment. We even had a member of the public ask why we were looking for plastic there because it's such a clean area. It's quite shocking to think that on just the surface of the sand, in 200 square metres, we picked up 106 pieces of plastic from this pristine beach. If we care at all about our oceans and ultimately our own future, we must stop the tide of plastic entering our oceans. The best way to do this is to stop using the plastic in the first place. There are small changes we can all make which will accumulate to make a big difference. It may seem useless, but we have to start somewhere.